You may not want to admit it, but at one time in your life, you've talked to an animal. Maybe it was letting a dog know that it was a good dog, or asking a cat where it's been. Maybe you gave words of encouragement to an elephant or scolded a sheep, whichever animal it was that you talked to. One thing is for sure, it probably didn't talk back. But what if it could? Scientists are working on ways to not only understand what animals are saying, but to one day talk back, forever changing the way that we think about them. So how close are we to talking with animals? Okay, I know what you're all saying. Animals do talk, just not with words. They make noises, they have facial expressions and body language. But this isn't exactly what we are talking about.
I think it's important to distinguish between what we call communication and language. Communication is the more general term, and it really refers to this exchanging of signals in a meaningful way. And language is a word that is fraught with interpretations and involved in many debates, whether other animals have language or are they communicating.
Well, the truth is that we suppose that animals have language, but in a lot of cases, we have to actually prove this experimentally.
No one has yet proven that an animal other than us has language, partly because the idea of what constitutes a language hasn't really been established. But in the broader sense, language should be distinct and organized patterns of communication with a near infinite number of combinations that have been learned and used voluntarily, not in a reactionary or instinctual manner. When your dog barks at a squirrel that runs past, this is a predictable instinctual response, so we don't consider it language. But there have been studies that show some do communicate in a very complex manner that show traits of language. Now, we just have to figure out how to decipher what they're saying.
I think the possibility of us having a Rosetta Stone with an animal is very real. What we have to do is we have to do the experiments to determine the context in which animal signals are given. And that context is going to give us the Rosetta Stone.
And that's exactly what's happening. Dr. Khan Slobachikov has been studying prairie dog calls because within those high-pitched chirps, they're actually saying a lot.
They are able to tell each other what the species of predator is, and the alarm calls are given in response to a predator. The prairie dogs tell each other whether the predator is a red-tailed hawk, is a coyote, is a domestic dog, or is a human. They can describe the physical features of the predator. So with humans, they can tell each other about the color of clothes that the person is wearing, about the general size and shape of the person, something about the speed of travel of the person.
Combining years of recorded prairie dog alarms with AI technology, he may one day be able to create a prairie dog to English translate.
Unfortunately, determining that animals have language is a difficult process. It's not an easy one. So it takes a lot of effort and time, and it takes a certain amount of money.
One of the main obstacles that slows us down from communicating with other species is that we don't have a shared code.
While Dr. Slobachikov is trying to use prairie dog language as the shared code, others are looking to create a new code, one that can hopefully bridge the gap between humans and animals.
We've now created a 4x8-foot touchscreen, an interactive underwater touchscreen for dolphins that will allow them choice and control, and it will allow us to understand what the kinds of signals they're using and their own interests, more about their cognitive abilities.
Dr. Reese and her team will observe the dolphins' choices and compare that to their vocalizations and mannerisms with the hope of decoding some parts of the dolphins' speech. Again, to create a Rosetta Stone to help translate and hopefully one day talk to dolphins using their language.
In our lab, we tried to give the dolphins a means of communication using a keyboard so that they could request and identify different objects. And that's what we're working on now, so that they can produce a code themselves.
Well, if it's so hard to learn their language, can't we just teach them ours? Isn't that an easier way to have an interspecies conversation? Maybe. For decades, scientists have been working with apes to teach them American Sign Language in order to learn more about both the species and the origin of human language.
So the first chimp was Washoe. She was wild caught by the Air Force. They were collecting chimps for the space program. Instead of going into space, she joined this sign language project. So she was raised like a human child, and all of her caregivers use American Sign Language.
Washoe was able to learn over 200 signs, talk to scientists, and even taught another chimp how to sign. More studies popped up, most famously with Coco the gorilla, and for a moment, the lines between human and animal blurred ever so slightly. Some were still skeptical, though, arguing that these apes were just mimicking the signs for reward instead of voluntarily conversing. And other studies were done that showed apes talking amongst themselves with signs and having private conversations with each other. They seemed to be using language voluntarily. Now, even though great progress has been made, some in this field do feel uncomfortable with the idea of bringing new apes or any animal into captivity to study.
As someone that's been doing this for a long time, I feel that this research should never be repeated. But the chimps that do have sign language, I feel that it's important for us to continue to document it and study it.
And that's what may be at stake here. That's why scientists are interested in studying interspecies communication and closing the gap between us and them.
I think if we could talk to animals, it would really change our relationship with them because people would realize that they are much more like us in many respects.
We are taught with our culture that we're so special and superior to other beings. When people see the chimps signing, it's like the chimps are reaching across that imaginary boundary that our culture has put up. For a lot of people, that just helps them to widen their circle of compassion.
It's going to really perhaps end what Lauren Isley has called the long loneliness of us being the only species that can communicate with each other. It would be very exciting to be able to communicate with other species on this planet.
If we were ever able to have a conversation with an animal, we'd first need to decode the sounds and movements that they make when communicating. This would be our Rosetta Stone, the groundwork for being able to talk back, a scenario that might change how we think, govern, work, innovate, and of course, eat. So how close are we to talking with animals?
So we really have to abandon our arrogance. And it's our arrogance that keeps us from communicating with other humans and other cultures. And it's our arrogance that has probably slowed our progress in understanding what non-humans are talking about.
We're already communicating with our animals in simple ways. If we then ask the question, how close are we to having a more sophisticated dialogue or exchange with other animals, I would say we still have a long way to go and we're just in the infancy of understanding how to do it. And I think it really requires decoding more of what they're doing in their own natural systems and finding ways of incorporating that into what we want to create as a shared code. So it's complicated, but it's intriguing.
Thanks for watching How Close Are We? Let us know in the comments what topics you'd like us to cover in future episodes. If you want more How Close Are We? Click here to watch our playlist, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.